Well, we're here with Julio Montana. We're just talking about the opening of the conference, the IIS meeting here in Vancouver, where we're talking from 1996, many years ago, a landmark moment in the face of AIDS. And now we're talking about yet another. Prevention is powerful.
Yeah.
The opening, well, not the opening, but the second press conference, which covered prevention broadly, showed and demonstrated the powerfulness of the epidemic and how the research has really come to its own. Now, just kind of give us an overview of some of the research.
Well, you know, as you know, this has been the culmination of a three-decade effort that really put us on the right track starting in 1996. Because the first decade was dark and gloomy. But once we hit 1996, with the emergency of NNRTI-based triple therapy and PI-based triple therapy, we basically had the fundamentals. Granted, it wasn't perfect. There were lots of missing pieces, but Vancouver 1996 changed the life of people infected with HIV forever. At the individual level. Mm-hmm. And that was very good because it really solved the emergency and opened the door for the role of antiretroviral therapy globally, and 15 by 15 eventually emerged. And here we are, 20 years later, celebrating historically the first time that the world has met a global public health goal. I mean, this is amazing. 15 million people have now been starting antiretroviral therapy, in fact, 9 months ahead of schedule. And we are now planning for the next target. And quite how appropriate that we're here in Vancouver coming out with all of these data that are going to fundamentally say we were right all along. We've been saying it for more than 10 years. If we optimize testing and treatment, and everything else that goes with it, because this cannot be done without addressing stigma and the legal framework under which we operate, and so on and so forth. But if we optimize testing and access to treatment, we can begin to see the end of the pandemic. And in fact, Michel Sidibe, Executive Director of UNAIDS, has been quite bold because a couple of years ago, he came to me and he said, Julio, we need to start working on the next goal because we're going to meet the 15 by 15, but we need guidance. How do we translate treatment and prevention into a tangible global goal or target that can drive us to the elimination of the epidemic or the pandemic? And that's when we started brainstorming and came up with a 90-90-90. And I tell you, that target was coined in Vancouver nearly 2 years ago at a very intense meeting, if you want. But I'll be the first to confess that it was tentative at that time, and that, yes, there was general support, but the vote was divided. And yet, we took it to Michelle, we did the work, we explored the feasibility of the target, and Ban Ki-moon, September 25th of last year, formally endorsed the proposed 90-90 target. And not only that, but John Kerry, President Zuma, and a number of leaders from multiple countries have now stepped to the plate and have endorsed it. Now, in tandem with that, what we have had is the evolution of the science that has come to help us to definitively consolidate the fact that the 90-90-90 target is actually the right thing to do. And so the Temprano study earlier this year and the START trial presented at this conference as we speak are irrefutable, conclusive, impeccable demonstrations that initiating antiretroviral therapy at the highest CD4 range of above 500 was associated with the half the progression of disease that those that delayed treatment were exposed to. A 50% for people who have normal immune system. This shows that the CD4 counts are an imperfect assessment of the immune function of a person infected with HIV. Because you can have a perfectly normal CD4, and yet you have double the rate of lymphoma or Kaposi's sarcoma, particularly cancers that are bad news. So we now can go back to the people that were hesitating about whether or not the so-called test and treat strategy was the way to go, and with a sense of urgency, and say, yes, this is the right thing for you. Mm-hmm. And for you and for your protection, we are going to recommend that you start antiretroviral therapy immediately. Mm-hmm. And by the way, secondarily, without any other effort, infrastructure, or investment, by doing that, we're going to protect your peers. Yes,
the whole community.
Everybody. Yeah, yeah. This is so perfect, because Myron Cohen today is releasing the data from the long-term follow-up of HPT-NO52 that definitively and conclusively showed that if you take the medications appropriately, you are 100% protected against transmission.
And the devil was in the details.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Because when they teased out the data, and he says, I don't know how many presentations they're going to be doing.
Half a dozen.
But the fact is that when they actually really analyzed the data and tortured it, they saw that it was actually, everything was explainable.
Oh, absolutely.
So it was 100%.
There were no failures of the treatment preventing transmission if the individual that was taking the treatment was taking the treatment appropriately, which actually fits with everything we know, because at the end of the day, this is biology 101. If there is virus, you transmit. If there is no virus detectable, you don't transmit. Yeah. And for the treatment to be effective, for my benefit as an individual, I had to suppress the virus. Mm-hmm. If I don't suppress the virus, it's hurting me. And so by doing the right thing for me, which means to be adherent to the treatment on a long-term basis, then I am basically no longer infectious. Now, I don't know if people yet realize how significant this is. Mm-hmm. To think that in 1981, we saw the emergence of a pandemic that we had no idea where it came from. And to think that in 2015, we are here, able to tell the world that we have a strategy to end the pandemic. I didn't say eliminate or eradicate HIV. That may continue to be a challenge, a sporadic challenge. But the pandemic, I mean, this is,
it's powerful.
For those of us that we were there, we never dreamt that this could happen. And for me to be able to host the world in 1996 to the welcome news that our own research had contributed to the definition of triple therapy, and for me to be able to, nearly two decades later, to say, hey, by the way, come over, we're going to show you the rest of the story. Because now, not only we can solve the individual problem, but we can solve the problem, the problem. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm in heaven.
I envy your position so greatly. But I envy being able to actually interview you in this moment, because we've had a lot of moments with you and Pedro Kahn and other times when we did interviews, and it was powerful to see, you know, the process and the points that we were able to achieve over time. And now we've got to this point where, you know, all the evidence is in. All we have to do is convince the leaders of the world. And I think, when Gottfried, mentioned, as he did from World Health, and you and Michelle Sidibe, I mean, we have some people here that can, when they impact, when they make the proper proposals and reach the right people, even in our country, there are counties in our country that are behind, that are Stone Age. I mean, we have to bring them to the table and have them educated.
You know, this is a very important point. What Vancouver is going to contribute this week here in IIS 2015 is to complete the package of evidence and the normative guidelines, because even though the normative guidelines are not out, we already know what they're going to say. We're going through the process of just editing the manuscript, so to speak. So we're going to come out of here saying, a test and treat, seek and treat, whatever you want to call it, universal access to antiretroviral therapy by everybody infected with HIV in the globe is an emergency, is a human right, is a fundamental next step. And then we're going to go to the political leadership of the world, and we're going to tell them, we remember when in 2001 in Angus, at the United Nations General Assembly, you people committed to fight this to the end. You committed to ending the AIDS pandemic. And at the time, that was an aspirational goal. Today, it's a fact. We have given you every answer. You ask us again and again and again for the definitive evidence. We have it. We have the roadmap. It's clear and it's fully defined.
So they have the opportunity and the responsibility.
Exactly. And they have nowhere to hide.
Right.
It is on you. You are either with us or against us. And if you are against us, you will be remembered as the enablers of the further spread and damage that AIDS caused over the years. And we are not going to tolerate that. Right. And we need the people of the world, because we live in a, for the most part, in a democratic world. We need the people of the world to turn on to their politicians and say, this is too big for you to walk away from it. Because I remind you, saves lives, saves infections, protects communities, reestablishes GDP, and is cost saving. Now, what is there not to like?
It's all that matters is implement it. It's just so simple. It's so straightforward. I'm excited to be here, and I think that it's not large. Well, there are large things that happened here at the conference, but collectively, it's massive.
It's massive.
It's absolutely massive.
You know, all of the pieces of the puzzle have come together to say, yes, we have a strategy, and you know, we've been talking about this for over a decade. I mean, none of this is new. We knew it was coming. We knew, but by having, and I could have argued, I mean, I'll be honest, that we didn't need any more evidence. In fact, I argued that 10 years ago. But, you know, the world is what it is, and people are where they are, and scientists are where they are, and it's fine. So we waited the 10 years, there was more suffering, more infection, more.
But now, it's irresponsible to wait any longer.
Now there are
action.
There are no remaining questions. No. The consensus at this conference, from Tony Fauci to Nora Volkoff, to Michel Sidibe, to the community, to the scientists, to the practitioners, to all of us, we are now convinced that there is only one way forward. And that is the most powerful thing coming out of here. We didn't have that in 1996. In 1996, we won the day, but it was a house divided. And it was only after time that we managed to get the consensus, the rally running behind Hart. It happened, but you know, it was challenging. Today, this is a celebration, and it's unanimous. There are no naysayers anymore.
Right. And the treatment is prevention. And
absolutely.
I'm excited to have, everyone should be tested. Everyone should know their status. Regardless of their risk, and the relative risk, I guess, incurs more testing.
Absolutely.
But obviously, this is the moment. Treatment is prevention.
Absolutely.
We've said that for a few years.
Yeah, of course. But now not only we say it, not only we hope for it, now we know it.
It's evidence.
And we have actually documented it to the decimal point.
Right.
And the decimal point says 100%.000. There is no doubt.
Thank you so much for being here. And thank you for having all of us to your city.
Absolutely.
I must say, this is a beautiful city. And I wished I could enjoy it more, but I'm enjoying the inside.
Thank you.